In this video, we talk about physically what's going on when a capacitor is charged. We introduce the idea of capacitance for a parallel plate capacitor. We talk about the units of capacitance, and we finish with a couple basic examples of capacitance calculations. So a parallel plate capacitor is just two conductive plates separated by a gap. So you should know that real capacitors are usually made by using two thin strips of foil separated by a piece of paper, but this parallel plate capacitor idea is a useful starting point. So in the circuit we're looking at here, we have a battery on the left, and that battery maintains a potential difference of V across its terminals. That's what a battery does. We have a parallel plate capacitor on the right, and it's currently uncharged, and we have a switch that allows us to complete the circuit and begin the charging process. It's important to realize here that batteries don't create charge, but they do cause charge to move around, such that the potential difference across the terminals is equal to V. So when we close the switch, charge begins to flow in this circuit. And positive charge is going to build up on the upper plates until the potential there is equal to the potential at the high side of the battery, and then the charge flow is going to stop. But there's a really important question: where did the plus charge come from? And since batteries don't create or destroy charge, this positive charge must have come from removing a charge of Q from the bottom plate. So when we talk about the Q in a capacitor, Q is just the magnitude of the charge on one of the plates. So there are two different ways to look at how this charge separation arises. And the first way is to say that positive charge was moving clockwise in the circuit. In other words, we were taking plus charges from the low side of that capacitor, we were pumping them up to this high potential through the battery, and they were landing on the high plate of the capacitor. And this process terminated once the potential difference across the capacitor was equal to the potential difference of the battery. Now, this is good for most practical purposes, but we know the real story is that atomic nuclei are fixed in place, and it's the electrons that are the charge carriers, and the electrons are negative. So in this view of things, we have electrons moving counterclockwise through the circuit. So what's happening here? Electrons from the high side of this capacitor, they're attracted to that plus terminal of the battery. They end up popping out the negative side, building up on the low plate of the capacitor. So how do I get the plus Q on the high side of the capacitor? That's a deficit of electrons. The minus Q on the other plate is an excess of electrons. So this is what's actually happening physically. All right, so how do we measure how good a capacitor is at storing charge? That's called the capacitance. And the capacitance is the charge per unit potential difference. If we look at the units of capacitance, it might clarify what I mean a little bit. The units of capacitance, and be careful, I'm using C in two different ways here. On the left, that's the capacitance. On the right, it's the units of charge, coulombs. Coulombs per volt. These units get a special name. They're called farads. And maybe to aid your intuition here, this definition of capacitance, it means that if a capacitor was twice as big, it would store twice as much charge for every volt of potential difference. All right, let's look at a couple simple examples. In the first example, we have a 100 microfarad capacitor charged to a potential difference of 5.5 volts. And I want to compute the magnitude of the charge on each plate. That's the Q from the formula. So if I want the Q from the formula, let's just turn the formula around and write Q equals CV. And I have a 100 microfarad capacitor. I'm just going to go ahead and leave the prefix of micro in there. And I have 5.5 volts of potential difference across the plates. And this gives me 550 microcoulombs of charge. So that's one way to answer the question correctly. If you want to write it in scientific notation, that's 5.5 times 10 to the negative 4 coulombs, just replacing that micro prefix with 10 to the negative 6. That's how I arrive at my scientific notation answer. In our second example, we're told that by observing the current over a period of time as a capacitor charges to 6.3 volts, we're able to measure a total charge transfer of 3.2 coulombs. So I actually did this in the lab a couple days ago, and I'll just go ahead and link to that video right now. So in this problem, we know the potential difference, and we know the amount of charge separation on the plates, so we should be able to get the capacitance from our basic definition, charge per volt. And so I put in my 3.2 coulombs of charge, my 6.3 volts of potential difference, and I end up with 0.2 0.51 farads. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.